So back in November last year, I checked out an application called Walling, and it was an application that sort of blended concepts of basic checklist abilities with the likes of Trello and sort of overlaying that with a Notion-esque design. And in today's video, what I want to do is check out some of the newer features inside of Walling, and I want to also dive into how it is trying at the moment to compare itself to many of the newer applications like Obsidian and Roam in introducing something called Graph View. I'll talk through it. It's not as advanced as, say, Roam, but we'll dive into it in today's video. Before we begin, a word from our sponsor. So folks, this month here on Keep Productive is one of my highly recommended project management tools, and that is ClickUp. Now, ClickUp is one of the fastest growing productivity and project management platforms in the last 2 years, and it's only been around for 2 years. They already have millions of users, and over 100,000 teams are using them at the world's best companies like Google, Airbnb, Uber, and Nike. Now, teams traditionally use spreadsheets, email, chat, and many project managers, but there's a big trend towards teams using just one application. Most teams replace three or more apps just by switching to ClickUp. So that process in itself, moving into one application, saves teams so much time. Now, ClickUp has features like tasks, docs, and goals to keep organized in one place and have fewer meetings, emails, and daily switches between multiple applications. And it's perfect for all types of teams, from 2 to 2,000, and from farming projects to even building aeroplanes. On top of that, they have an extremely generous free forever plan. You can literally add unlimited users and unlimited work to their app for free. So guys, you can find out more about ClickUp below. I recommend checking them out. They also do have a Just Me plan if you wanted to switch to some of your own personal work too. So thanks again to ClickUp for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. So here we are on Walling. As I said, checked it out a while ago. As you can see, if you compare it to the last video we did, it actually has changed. It's a little bit neater. I think the last time I checked it out actually was one of the first, or the first week it was released. But actually, on the left-hand side, you didn't have some of these new entries. So I want to start with some of the newer features. So on the top left, you had what was called desk, but now you have a daily desk. So some of the ways and concept that they've used has worked, and that's minimizable, so you can drop it out. Very minimal, this application. And you can also see they've added in these really attractive designs to make it a little bit more friendly, very bear-like, bear notes-like, if you're someone that follows that. So from here, what you can do is you can do very simply collect ideas. And they want you to start like dumping articles. They want you to start dumping, you know, short notes to yourself. So you can double tap to enter a note. And it's very similar to what it was last time. So in this demonstration, I'll just put, you know, like book recommendation. And below I can maybe add something like the power of habit. And you can add, for example, checklists, modify the heading, the link, etc. And you can even insert all of the other stuff like dividers, quote codes, files. And let's add an image for this demonstration. So as you can see, very simple, very easy to use. But there's this sort of new button at the top, and you can add what's called a node to it. And it's essentially a tag. If you put it in sort of layman's terms. So I could basically connect this one to book, and you can add another tag if you want to it. In this case, it could be business as well. So I've connected it to two nodes as part of my account. So as you can see, the collecting of ideas is centralized to today, but you can go to the next day and all of the other ones will disappear. So you could, for example, start doing your to-do list for the next day, or a week in advance, and have sort of a clear concept every day. Very similar to Canvas-like applications like MailerNote. This helps you to maybe refocus on a certain item. You can also have pinned items. We actually had a few pinned items last time, and you can toggle between having them pinned or not. Just showing the pinned ones, they might be the most important things. So you can clip whatever you like, book recommendations, articles that you need to read, checklists that you need to get done. You can open them up and start interacting with them there. So they're, you know, very expansive in terms of being able to immerse yourself into them. And you can also go back and forward using this link here. But the real magic is in the connect area. So if I went to connect, you'd get these sort of like three tabbed areas, one called wizard, one called graph, and one called folders. So if I wanted to find a business related book that has both the business and the book tag or node, then you can see that that pops up there. So for example, if I want to do the same with say courses, anything that I've been courses, ideas or notes that include that, then I can have that there. So the nodes are essentially a way to connect up existing things. And the cool thing that you can do with this is if, say, you wanted a full wall in walling, you can create these things called walls that essentially you can organize a bit like a Trello board to some extent. So if I wanted to, for example, make a wall out of this, I could go ahead and copy to a wall and create a brand new wall based on book and business nodes. So that would help me to drill down bits of information inside of my account. And that can be very helpful when you've got a lot of links, you've got a lot of files, you've got a lot of information that you're adding to. And the company actually mentioned that they do want to try to become some form of second brain for you with you adding this information. So once you're happy with the nodes you've chosen, you can go over to the graph view, and that connects up any of the areas that, for example, you've got connected up. So in this case, you've got business, books, and you can quickly enter there. But the cool thing is you can move this around, and as you add more and more, naturally things will connect up. So in this case, I may have book, business, and then book art, book productivity, book science, book art history, etc., etc., with all of the different areas and aspects of life. And they would get bigger. I'll show you a few demonstrations of what it actually looks like when it's working in full capacity. So a very, very simplified version of what Rome is doing. Very, because you're not able to necessarily connect up notes like that. This is just more like visualizing tags. But they do want to be able to, in the future, be able to expand this and make it even more, connected with your notes. You can also go to folders and you can create a new node. You can create a new collection. And new collections is essentially just like a folder for your tags. A new node is a way for you to create these new nodes with colors. So if I wanted to create a new node like productivity books, I'd go and create it. And if I go back to the wizard, I could actually remove this one and add productivity to it. And if I go to the graph, you can see that it becomes a lot more interactive right there. So the one thing they've done is introduce search. And what's cool is they've used AI, I think it may be some form of API that allows you to search images as well. So for example, if I wanted to type in The Power of Habit, that book comes up there. But if I chose a specific thing that's not in any of the text, so let's go with the New York Times. Okay, I can't seem to demonstrate it with the thing that I had in mind, the book. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a picture of some elephants. I'm not going to add any tags. I'm going to say animals to it. And what I'm going to do is go to the search and type in elephants. So there we go. It's able to analyze the image and see what it's relevant to. So it can do that for any of the images that you do have. So what's cool is if you created nodes inside of the different aspects of your work, when you're adding new bricks and new areas, well, they're not called areas, they're called sections, you can then connect things up a little bit easier. So for example, if I wanted to add the 4-hour work week, that's both a productivity book and a business book. So if I went and added an image of it, and I went back up to connect and went to the graph, you can see here that the actual productivity section has gotten a lot bigger than, say, the course, the business, and journal. So you can see that any section that's added, you can see all the books that are relevant there. So this is a great way to filter down. It's just a glorified filtering system at the moment, but I can see that this being adding over time, you know, more and more links and more files can be very helpful. So folks, that was walling, and that's some of the new concepts. Now, I talked a little bit more about the basic elements of it inside of the previous video. You can check that one in the link in the description. Currently still has premium, which is $4 per user per month. and that gives you access to unlimited access, which is fairly reasonable. Sort of Notion pricing, although it doesn't do as much as Notion, it's much more simple and much more fine-tuned in ways because you're doing a certain activity. But the one thing that you'll need to note is these are sort of a new form of applications. Supernotes, the one we did recently, this one, the likes of Walling, and a few others are sort of merging into this new hybrid space where they sort of hover around the major applications like Roam, Evernote, Notion, and Obsidian, and many more, Dynalist, Workflowy. They're sort of acting as these half note takers that allow you to sort of take lighter weight notes in more of a Google Keep fashion than, say, a Roam fashion. But very interesting, because I can see both Walling, Supernotes, Columns, all appealing to people that seek an easier, more manageable way to take on their productivity. So folks, I will be keeping an eye on Walling. I believe the team let me know they have some pricing changes soon. I believe they got free plans, so that might be more accessible. I see them develop quite fast, so I'm pretty impressed with that. Although it has been a solid 6 months, they've added a fair amount to it and changed a few of the concepts behind it. So folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do subscribe if you're brand new, and I look forward to sharing more with you in a future video. Anyway, folks, cheerio.